Hello guys, what's going on? My name is Hiroshi from WebSalePress.com. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here, we share software engineering tutorials on this channel. If you want to learn and grow in this area, join us by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. In this tutorial, we are exploring event handling and event binding in React.js. How to capture an event in React.js and perform some action based on it. If you click on a button, that is an intentional event. By clicking a button, a user wants to perform some action. In JavaScript, we attach an event listener to events that listens to the event. When that event happens, we trigger a callback or a function call or some action. Similarly, we have to bind that event in React to listen to it. Let's create a simple example to demonstrate it. This is a simple React app containing a class-based component, and the output is here. So, event handling in React.js. Handling events with React elements is very similar to handling events on DOM elements. So supported events are clipboard events, composition events, keyboard events, focus events. So here are the mouse events: on click, on mouse up, on mouse over, on mouse out. We use on click often. And these are the form events such as on change, on input, on invalid, on submit. And these are focus events: on focus, on blur. Keyboard events: on key down, on key press, on key up. So let's create an example. So this is a button. When user clicks at this button, we have to capture that event and bind that event before we perform some kind of action on it. So let's create an event handler. On click, this dot handle click. This handle click is a name, it can be anything, and this keyword is being used just because I am using class-based component. Let's define our state constructor. Super props. This dot state, and here's the object of state, and here is our counter that is 0. Let's display this counter inside our button. This dot state dot counter. So the counter is being displayed. If I change its value to some different value, it will be displayed here. It will reflect here. Okay, so I want to use this event handler for this counter. So for this event handler, I have defined a function. Let's use this function. This is my function. this dot set state counter, this dot state dot counter plus one. Alright, so on click, this function should get triggered and this state should be incremented by one. So we have used an event handler and we have used a function for that. Our logic is in that function, but we need to bind this. In the constructor, we will use this dot handle click, that is our function, this one. This dot handle click is equal to this dot handle click dot bind this. Let's try this now. We have a spell mistake here. So the counter is working now. So here is our event handler and this is our function. So function, and inside this function we are incrementing this state, and we are incrementing by one. But this function is not working if we don't bind this like this. So if there are many functions like these, different kinds of functions, you have to bind each function like this. Personally, I like to use a different method to bind these functions or bind these event handlers. You can do it like this, or you can just use arrow function. If I use the arrow function, our counter will work just fine. But if you don't use the arrow function, you will have to bind this event. This binding is necessary to make this work in the callback. I find arrow function method more convenient for me. And if you want to pass the parameters, you can do it like this. Like, I am passing 4 with this function. And I will get this parameter here, and I will use this its value, this argument, instead of that static number 4, 8, 12. Now it is being incremented by this parameter. So if I use 10 here, 10, 20, it will be incremented by number 10. You can read more about event handling at the React.js documentation, and at the end they have also explained how you can pass the arguments to event handlers. And if I use any other event handler here, like on mouse over instead of on click. So on mouse over, now instead of click, on mouse over will work. So this is the event handling in React.js for you. I hope you liked the video. If we missed anything or you have something to add or share, comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive channel updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description, and stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.